Hello everyone, I'm Moth, and today I'm excited to show off this newer version of the Hexadecimal Reader because this one is more than twice as fast. To show you what I mean, I prepared a few examples. So first, we'll start off with Hello World, because that's what I showed off in the last video. We place it up here, and we punch to start. We'll see that this is a lot faster than before. It uses the Jude box as the clock, and also outputs the zero when we need it to. Because of how fast this is, I'm much more happy to do a tutorial on this one. We'll also show off the 0 to 15 one. Like before, we put it here, then we press to start. As you'd expect, this'll count up from 0 to 15. There we go. With that all said, let's pop into another world and start building this for the tutorial. Please keep in mind that this is only available for the newer snapshots and pre-release of 1.19.4. So, if you're on any other versions, you'll sadly be disappointed. To get started on this hexadecimal reader, we will need all these supplies, along with some temporary blocks, some scaffolding, and something to break those temporary blocks with. To get started, we'll start with a barrel and put three hoppers in like so. We'll then put a hopper going into that one, and then two hoppers right here. We'll then put a hopper going into it, a temporary block here, our Jude box there, and then a hopper going into that Jude box, and a hopper going into that one. So, at the end of it, it should all look like this. We'll then put two temporary blocks here and break this one. We'll put our dispenser in like that, so that's facing into this block. And then put our two minecart with hopper in here. And be sure to have at least two, or else this machine won't work properly. We get rid of this one, and we'll start putting some blocks here and one right there. We can get our rails and a lever. Put the lever here. This will be to power these power rails. We'll put one there. And put the other power rail there. We need to put this rail here just so that we can make this power rail slanted. Then we can get rid of it there. On this spot, while we're here, we can put some redstone dust there. And on top of the Jude box. We then get rid of this iron block and put another iron block right there. We put an iron block right here, a rail right here, another iron block there with a rail right here. And we can put our last two hoppers like so and our last rail on top of that. We'll then put a temporary block here, an iron block there, and get rid of that. We can go up and we put our cactus in. And this string is just to keep the cactus from not growing, but if you want your cactus to grow, don't put a string on it. So at the end of all that, it should look a little something like this. We'll then go around the back here, and we'll add two blocks here, temporary block here, and another block there. We'll then get a target block and place it here, another temporary block, and put two more iron blocks there. We'll go up and we'll place redstone dust there, a repeater set to 3. And then on top of this, we'll put a redstone comparator, a block, and a redstone torch. So it should look something like this. We'll get rid of this block here. We'll get rid of that block. And we'll put our redstone dust. So it should be powering this hopper, and it should be reading from this hopper, which is pointing into our Jude box. And lastly, we'll put some blocks like so. We'll put another comparator here. Our repeater set to 3. Redstone dust here. 2 blocks like so. And redstone dust on there. Oops. Not there, but right here. And then we'll put our target block like that. We'll put our last torches here. And our last redstone dust right here. We'll then put 2 iron blocks here. And another iron block right here. And right here. We'll put our repeater here. And this one will be set to 4 ticks. And another repeater here set to 2 ticks. We'll then put a temporary block there. A note block. And a carpet on top. Just to keep it silent. There can be any block on this one, but carpet's small. We'll then break this one and put our observer right here. And then, to finish it all, we'll put a comparator on this block. Now that that's built, I've prepared a little test right here. As it says, test. So, whenever you want to read something, you can just place your barrel here and press the start button. And it should work. You know, should work. If it's built correctly, if all of the ticks are correct, so this one's set to 3, this one's set to 4, this one's set to 2, and this one is also set to 3. And all the things should be received down here. And with that, thanks for tuning in and hopefully learning something new and creating something awesome in your own world. I'm Moth, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye!